Good afternoon to all. I am Dr. Kamali, working as Associate Professor with the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Chitkara University. And the topic that I am going to cover today is cloud computing. So cloud computing is a domain which is very much in predominance in today's scenario. Reason being why it's so much popular is its usage. It's easy usage, it's easy interface that provides easy accessibility to all its stakeholders. And primarily two stakeholders in cloud domain are mostly referred. First one is consumer and second one is producer. So before discussing why cloud computing is important, it is very much imperative to know what is cloud computing. It is actually composed of two important metaphors. First one is cloud and second one is computing. Cloud is something that spans across the entire world. That is why the cloud metaphor has been associated with it. And computing refers to processing capabilities. So together, processing capabilities that are offered over internet to any of the user sitting across any part of the world computes cloud computing. And now why cloud computing is important? Because there are several reasons why cloud computing is predominantly used in today's world. First one is elasticity. Elasticity refers to the provisioning of services to the consumers on demand basis, as and when required. When user require resources, they can acquire the resources over cloud, and when they no longer needed it, they can release the resources. Second one is on demand self-service. It is self-adaptive in nature, and whenever required, the resources can be acquired over cloud. Location independence gives all the resources and services are provisioned over internet without checking the geographical disparities. From your mobile phones, laptops, any of IoT device, you can access whatever data you want to access or whatever service you want to access from any of the service provider. Multi-tenancy architecture is something that talks about sharing of infrastructure or resources, same resources by multiple users over different time zones. Resilient computing is somewhat related to disaster management. Resilient computing says, in case of disasters, flood or any kind of drought or any kind of disaster situation that has occurred over one area can be easily resolved. The data won't get destroyed as multiple capabilities of multiple copies of data are maintained over internet. So resilient computing basically deals with mirrored capabilities of cloud. Next, we have reduced cost and maintenance, as the user who wants to directly use the cloud platform doesn't have to undergo the implications of purchasing the initial cost of software or maintaining the software, upgrading to the latest version, as it is already over implemented on cloud platform. And the implementation tasks are fast in nature. User is free from botheration of software updates because different vendors have different processing capabilities available with them. So different versions of software are available over cloud platform by different kind of vendors. And user have flexibility too in choosing any of the application of his choice, any of the version of his choice. Another benefit that is offered by cloud computing is scalability of resources. Scalability of resources means any of the service provider plus the consumer can add on or release any of the resources as when required. There is no restriction on number of resources that can be acquired by the consumer or that can be provided by the service provider. It all depends upon the agreement that has taken place between the consumer and the provider. Cloud is a utility-oriented model. We have already seen and we have already made use of electricity and gas consumption in our home places. Whatever amount of electricity we are consuming, after some fixed duration of time, we are paying amount for only the amount of usage we have done. So utility-oriented model is a very good feature of cloud computing because it offers measured service to its users. Only the amount for which a resource particular has been acquired for a particular time, for that particular period of time, the user has to pay for the quantity consumed. Now, cloud is secure in nature because at various stages of data, whether it is in REST, whether it is in transmit stage, any of the stage, the data is in the security feature has been enabled by cloud service providers. So user need not bother about importing security into the data at any of the stage. It has unlimited storage capacity. And the advantages that have been offered by cloud computing leads to development of new applications and services as its prominent area. That is why storage is another area. We have easily access to backup of the resources and the data that is available onto the cloud, that too in very much secure manner. Then cloud computing is primarily used for hosting of websites and blogs. We have delivery of softwares on demand. Analysis of data too takes place in cloud computing at an easy and faster rate. Then cloud computing is also helpful in streaming videos and audios. So these are some of the benefits that the cloud computing offers that easily extends and helps in its expansions and has made it very much popular among the existing stakeholders. There are different dimensions and areas where cloud computing has prominently been used. First one is test and development, and for test and development of any of the platform or software application, there are a number of cloud vendors available. For example, we have Red Hat as one of its vendor that provides very easy access to development of any of the coding thing in any of the platform in which user is comfortable. Then disaster recovery is another area where cloud computing is primarily used, and we have heard about Amazon and Azure site recovery platform that is very much prominently used for making its place in case of any of the disasters occurring place at any region of the world. Then backup and storage of massive data is another application that cloud offers, and for implementing it we have box.com and Mozy as its vendors. Online software library and education is another field in which cloud is predominantly very much used. And for enabling it, we have Amazon Web Services and Google Apps. For website hosting as an area of cloud computing, AWS S3, DigitalOcean, and Microsoft Azure are the vendors that are primarily used. Then cloud is very much used in e-commerce applications as well for social marketing and social exchange of goods and services. And for its Salesforce.com is a very good example. Then for social implementations, we have Facebook, we have WhatsApp. These are the applications that are making use of cloud computing. And in the field of art, in the domain of art, cloud computing is very much used for development of Visa cards and everything. And for that, we have Moo, Vistaprint. Cloud computing, with the cloud computing enabling technology, it is also convenient for user to print wedding cards. So these are also some of the areas where cloud computing is used, and the most commonly used feature of cloud computing is in business applications, and for that we have vendors like MailChimp, Bittrex24, PayPal for handling of online payments. Then in entertainment, apart from social media, besides it, we have online games and video conferencing, and for it we have vendors like Vortex, Project xCloud, PlayStation Now. So these are some of the applications that are that have captured the market in its entirety, and that is the reason why cloud computing is so much used. Besides that, there is one other area, that is research, in which cloud computing is attracting a lot of researchers. Reason being, though cloud offers so many advantages, but still it is nowadays facing so many challenges as well in its implementation, like security, energy management, resource management, scheduling. These are some of the areas in which researchers are finding their contributions for easier implementation of cloud computing. And we are expecting that within next one decade, cloud computing is going to capture the entire world of technological era in its entirety. So in case you have any kind of questions regarding to cloud computing, or you have any kind of suggestions that you want to present, you can contact me anytime. Thank you so much for your patience listening. Thank you.